Hi everyone, AJ here, and I have yammered on about this game long enough since we've been doing this Let's Play series, so I am finally going to do a Let's Play of my absolute favorite game in the world, Wild Arms. This is the original one, and my faithful companion, Hawk, is going to be sitting in on it.
Hawk here.
Hello, that's a little loud. There we go. So, this is my favorite game. It's been my favorite game since, middle school. Forever since you came out.
I met you.
You didn't know me back then.
No, but I did buy you the remake for what, Christmas?
Yeah, you did. When we first started dating, you bought me Alter Code F, and as well as 4 and 5.
Also true.
And I talked you into buying 3, and now we actually have two, I think we have or had, two copies of Wild Arms 3.
Yes, that is true. And I gotta say, as much as I do have other favorite games, I do think on a technical level, Wild Arms 3 may be the perfect RPG.
You know, it's really up there. I mean, it's like, one will always have a near and dear place to my heart, but if I were to tell someone to play one game out of the series, it would be 3.
Yeah, definitely give it a try if you haven't. I know it's available on like PS3, potentially PS4 for download. You can probably find it used cheap online for the PS2 if that's where you need to go, or find it any other way you can.
Oh, Mario. A lot of people mistakenly think that's Cecilia. That's Mario.
You know, I can see that, especially at this level of pixelization.
Yeah, with a lot of hair and magic. That's Cecilia. I do love her.
And that's her pet, Rocky.
Should name it Rocky. And there's Rudy doing who the fuck knows. Rudying.
Well, the mountain
putting his life in mortal peril because he just fucking feels like it. That's just how he does.
Kurama from Yu Yu Hakusho is his idol.
This could put my life in mortal peril. Gotta do it.
Yeah, it's only fair because last night the mountain climbed him.
Oh my god. Just stop it. Nobody knows that joke.
No, that's a big throwback.
Only 3 people know that joke.
And 2 of them are us.
Hey, let's smile at each other. Yay! Oh my god, 90s Jack. Oh, it's painful. I do like how they updated their looks in Alter Code a lot. Like,
so where Jack never drew his sword?
Okay, that I have beefs with. And if we happen to do Alter Code F, which I hope we do, I am going to go off on that. Okay? I am going to absolutely go off on that fact. Alright, so let's go ahead and get a new game started here.
Oh, I guess while we're at it, thank you for joining the party. Let's go on an adventure.
Oh, God.
You thought you were going to get away from it.
A wandering youth. Just remember all the jokes we made last time we played this. Yes, last time, which, by the way, I should get this out of the way, which I meant to do sooner. I am going to be using the infinite item trick. The infinite item duplication trick. So, if you have a problem with that, take it up with our complaints department, which, by the way, is me, and I'll just tell you to bug off. Okay, this game is 20-some-odd years old, thereabouts.
At this point, we're mostly just going to be using it to save time and effort on things and make things a little quicker on you.
Either way, my point is, this game is old as hell as far as JRPGs go, and I have played it so much I can quote this freaking game in my sleep. I am going to cheat it. Get over it.
Well, I guess narration. We're not voicing this at the moment.
Yeah, I know, right? We're just talking. Okay,
we're calling it a day, kid. Thanks a lot. The barrels are all sorted.
Oh, you just want to do the mayor voice.
Oh, I was hoping you'd forgotten. I was waiting to bring
I am not going to forget Mayor Bannett.
I hired you at the recommendation of Mayor Piffer.
Piffle.
At Mayor Hiffle, you turned out to be okay. By the way, what's your name?
Well, you would think you would hire him knowing his name. It just, that's so stupid.
Yeah. Sure, I may have hired you, but I have no idea who you are or who to make the checkout to.
Hey, kid.
Rudy, you're stronger than you look. The horses seem happy. Where's the intersection? How do those cross over? Do not answer these questions.
That guy's face just looks so messed up.
Here's today's pay. Sorry, kid. This is all this village can afford.
He has all the village's funds.
You also got the joy of doing what you did to the horses.
I love that when they give him an item, they hold it up in a sparkle.
Oh, yeah, the Zelda's do-do-do-do.
Yeah, that's cute.
You should see if the mayor has any more work for you. Thanks again. See ya.
All right, which one is it?
Oh, we finally get to bring out Mayor Bannett.
Rudy, asshole chickens. Waiting. Oh, shit. Which is this one?
Rudy, the chicken jerk.
Oh my god, where's the chicken? Is it you?
Hashtag, where's the chicken?
Hey! Oh yeah. Maybe in that. Okay, maybe it's you. Don't make him. Ah! I'll find that chicken later.
Note how many times she said she's played this game and knows everything.
I expected to get it on the first hit, to be honest, because I have done it before. My husband tells me that you've been working hard. You must be tired. I bet your husband tells you lots of things. Everything she's like, my husband tells me not to talk to you. Don't interest. No.
Come back if you get tired.
Hello, Mayor Bannett.
Rudy, how are you? Thanks to you, the stables are in great shape. Take these as a token of my appreciation. Long ago, I found these bombs while exploring ancient ruins.
You just gonna give them to a miner you don't know.
In which way do you mean minor?
O-R.
You may find them handy. Tool bombs acquired. These bombs will destroy most small objects. Walk next to the object you want to blow up and push the tools button. I think you're a dumbass because I'm explaining how explosives work.
Wait, what's a tools button?
I don't have buttons, old man. Oh god, he's peered behind the veil! He's peered behind the veil! Get him!
It will go off in a bit. These magical bombs will never run out. In the good old days, magic berries could be found in the cave to the south.
Note that he talked about magic berries.
Mm-hmm.
We would use the bombs to clear debris from the caves. Now that all the berries are gone, we no longer need them. Explosives only have one use in this town. One, that's it.
Because you banned all the other uses.
The world is fading and our village is starting to feel the impact.
So.
That's all.
Mayor Bannett, he came up with that when I played this game a few years back. And Mayor Bannett has been a running gag.
What, now, for a decade?
Forever.
Excuse me, I must talk to the mayor immediately.
Oh, it's the same guy from earlier.
Mayor Pfeiffer, a child from our village has gone into the berry cave.
What?
What do we do?
We pace.
I'm walking angrily. The berry cave is full of monsters. Maybe if we had some explosives, but no, that's clearly not an option. There is not much we can do. I must talk to the townsfolk about this situation. Please keep this quiet. We can't have the people panicking. The cows, sure, but not the people.
Was that the chicken to the left of this house here?
It might be. I was wondering if she'd say something different. Dip.
Hashtag too many chickens.
No, get over here, you freaking. There it is! The light shroom you will probably never use.
My god, you hit a chicken so hard it turned into a mushroom. I have questions.
And because this is Wild Arms. Everyone does this. You have to do this.
You're kind of required.
Tony's mom. Tony, where could he be? Okay, if my kid was missing, I wouldn't just be pacing my house screaming, like, where could you be? And just shouting their name. I'd be, like, tearing apart, like, everything over them. I hope he's not causing trouble in the village.
Good news, he's not in the village.
Oh, she doesn't know if the kid's missing.
My son Tony, he may seem wild, but he's really a good kid. His smiling face has helped me through my illness. An unnamed illness that will never come up again.
Ooh, you send that dog flying. Oh my god, you've merged them into a dog chicken.
I think actually the dog will chase you.
Not if he's part chicken. Oh god! You almost turned him into a flying dog.
My god, Rudy, you're an asshole to animals.
Cruelty to animals, only at MHP Gaming.
Get out of here, doggo.
Ha 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 ha
Gotcha.
Remember what we said before about we're going to try not to waste your time?
Not today.
Yeah, today is not that day.
God, I can't believe they put that one chicken in alter code that will turn you vegan.
What?
Yes. So, Cecilia has her little magic wand that lets her talk to animals, and there's a chicken in alter code that says, "Where are my children? They take my eggs every day." I'm like, oh my god, that's horrible. Alright.
At first I thought you were going to say like it had like magic that made you into a vegan, or like vegan powers like from Scott Pilgrim.
That's horrible. Nothing against vegans, but I like meat. Wow, I look away for a second and this kid gets past me. No one from the village is allowed in here. What am I to do?
Go after him. Make an effort. Something? No trespassing. Bats bring danger. Leave now.
Yeah.
What was that, haiku? No trespassing. Bats bring danger. Leave now.
Those monster graphics, though.
This game should have never tried for semi-3D battles.
It should not. Seriously. I know it was something they were... It was a shiny new toy they were all excited to try, but this is just... If there's one criticism I really have against this game...
I've tried to play this game through. I honestly only made it so far. I didn't think it was bad, but just... Honestly, the battle system is kind of just a turn-off the way they do it.
I like the battle system. I don't like the battle graphics.
Yeah, I don't like the way they implemented it to the graphics. The battle system is fine, but I don't know. It's just one of those hard to it's one of those hard to quantify things. Just either you like it or you don't.
Mm-hmm.
It's like how you shouldn't have to explain what flavors of something you like. You just sometimes you just like something or you don't.
Yeah, it wasn't until I played later games that I figured out those things are like slime covered and that's what they're hitting you with. I could never figure that out as a kid. Never in my freaking life. Now, there's one change I do like that they made in Ultra Code. It's making Rudy just use the gun. Like, he uses a sword and a gun. I mean, my god.
True enough.
What is he, Instructor Sarah? No, Instructor Sarah, she thinks she's Rudy. I already think that game has enough in common with Wild Arms. I don't need that, too.
Trails of Cold Steel reference. 50 Gela acquired.
Gela, Jella. Gela, I like Gela.
Well, red balloons do spell danger.
I know, right?
We have two red balloons.
There we go. I was going to say, Rudy, where the hell is your high counterattack rate? Normally he counterattacks like a motherfucker. It's one of the things I like about him. Except in times when you don't like that about him. Yeah, he can make it a real pain in the butt trying to farm objects sometimes in Alter Code with that obscenely high counterattack of his. I'd be like, okay, I need to kill these enemies this certain way to get this item. Like, use Cecilia's magic something, Rudy. Counterattack, counterattack, counterattack. And I'm like, you stupid bastard. Stop it!
Oh yeah, I forgot this game actually gets that in-depth with item collection.
Mm-hmm. This one I don't think did.
Oh, that was Alter Code, that's right.
Yes.
Mm. You don't want that apple?
Huh?
You don't want the apple?
What do you mean?
You're not gonna use it?
Not right now.
Okay.
I'm using it for my duplication.
Oh, that's right.
Confusing me here. I was debating if I want to use a heal barrier or if I just want to run back to the town and rest, but, you know, I know this game well enough. I love this.
Remember that for when she dies.
Don't destroy this sign. Birdie is such a dick. He's really not. I could picture him being like, why are you making me hurt these animals? I love animals. I'm not like this. I'm like the nicest guy on the planet. I'm so nice, I just stand there and let other people walk all over me.
If he was so nice, he wouldn't have did what he did to the horses.
Still don't want to know what happened.
I want to know why he got paid for it.
I'm pretty sure he brushed them lovingly, and I mean their coats.
Yeah, I know. That's its own reward. So why would you get paid for it?
That one didn't catch me. Ah, that did! Suck. Game. Yay, preemptive strike. Woohoo.
They should have just done a nice fancy 2D battle style.
They really should have.
I know that was kind of on the way out at this point, but still, I mean... It's better to have something... Rather than reach too far and end up with something that just doesn't work, it's better to just stick with what you know and create something, you know, with its own quirkiness, with its own uniqueness.
Whoops. Alright, now Final Fantasy VII was 2D, right?
That was 3D.
Okay.
Yeah, I think that, yeah, that was their first foray into 3D.
Yeah. This game came a little bit before that.
Yeah, this was like, wow, like a month before? No, wait, but this came out like a month or two after. Wasn't that about it?
This game came out, I want to say, November or December of 96 in Japan. Oh, the goblins.
Yeah, and if
these
I remember,
guys will wreck you.
Yeah, this came just out in America, just in the wake of Final Fantasy VII, which good luck competing with that. And they also looked, well...
Oh, shit.
Debatably better. I mean, looking back, I'm not going to say Final Fantasy VII was great, but at the time, it was really good. And it's going to be hard for some people to understand looking back at it, but you know, back in the day, VII looked impressive.
Like I've said before, there's one thing to appreciate about Rudy is his counterattack and critical.
It's his ability to take a punch and do something about it.
I know.
I like how the goblins meow when you hit them.
I know! They're the only ones that do, but...
Yeah. Wild arms, for when you want things to meow when you stab them.
Fun fact, if you run down this hallway, you'll get a little bat following you and it takes the encounter rate up. Not sure how people do that.
Yeah, that sounds like a really fun obscure fact.
Mm-hmm. I've done it on purpose for funsies. Tazzlebelm. Oh, that's pretty sure that's a mistranslation there. Damn you.
Damn, he did something about it.
I told you, man.
Don't hit me!
That's what he does.
Well, apparently he crits well, too.
Yeah, I told you, his counterattack and his crit rate are just freaking crazy. Like I said, I've had him pretty much counter entire battles. And I'm really glad they kept that in Alter Code.
Well, that's kind of his key defining feature. You couldn't do it without him.
Aside from just being Mr. Nice Guy in general.
Level up.
Level up. That's right, this game's not nice enough to heal you on level ups. Or did it?
No. Well, it did give you a pretty fair amount more experience or hit points.
Yeah.
Holy symbol of water.
Yeah, that's how you get rid of the bat. So it's like even if you ran down the hallway and got a bat, it's not a big deal. You can purge it with that.
Does the bat ever show up ever again?
You know, I don't think it ever does. It's one of those, like, random status ailments that's only ever used, like, one time.
So you're going to have that item forever with nothing to do with it?
Yeah, pretty much. I don't think I have ever come across another case. I do think Cecilia may have a spell that does just that, that will raise the encounter rate and you can use it for training.
Can you get the bat a second time?
I don't know, maybe. If you ran back down that hallway?
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. Can you do that twice?
Probably.
Does it go away when you leave the cave?
The bat?
Yeah.
I think it stays with you until you either use the symbol or, you know, do a healing thinger.
Okay. Then that'd be a jerk move for them to give you a second bat you can't cure without the holy symbol.
You can buy one.
Oh, never mind.
You can buy them.
Okay. I forgive you, game.
It's game's not that big of an asshole.
I mean, it is, but not that big.
It can be an asshole, but not quite that bad.
Instant death foxes?
Oh yeah, the instant death foxes. I have been screwed over by them many times. Or just like getting trapped in a dungeon with not nearly enough healing items. Okay, I thought that was supposed to go up first. Right away, I'll go activate these.
Bonnie, Bonnie.
Bonnie, Bonnie. I'm gonna need those heal berries. I don't have Cecilia just yet. Okay, so I could use one power apple, but I'm just gonna save it.
Well, if you want to use the dupe trick, you gotta use it eventually.
Yeah, I know. Honestly, that's something I may just do off camera.
Yeah, fair point.
You know, just go ahead and dupe and do my, shove my characters with apples.
Eat! Eat! I can't eat anymore, sir! You will eat until you can punch a tree down.
They'll be like that Sultan in Aladdin with Iago shoving him the crackers. I'll be my characters with the power apples.
Meanwhile, Cecilia would just be like, wow, that sounds delightful.
She likes food. Cecilia gets me. Alright, bullet refills. Yes. Savey. Alright. Save point. What could possibly lie ahead? Oh, a room
love
opening
and peace.
Up. Oh, look, here's the kid. Might just be the end of his battle. Or dungeon.
I've come to look for berries for my father. The berries are on the other side of this block pack. This passage.
Well, tear it down, kid. Expect me to come here and freaking do all your work.
Eat a power apple and punch it.
Who punches down a brick wall? God damn it.
Who has ineffectual bombs?
He's like, fine, I'll just walk through the water and get it for you.
Bandana acquired.
He's just that freaking nice, guys. He's that freaking nice.
Speaking of the glitch, though, you couldn't really do it until later anyway. You need a full party.
Yeah, I know.
I know, I'm just mentioning for the audience.
I think I'll be alright. Doo-dee-doo-dee-doo.
The berries faintly shimmer. Holy berry acquired.
I'm mad that that's the only one of these you ever get.
Thank you. With these berries, I can heal my father. Let's hurry. I've got to get them to him right away.
And this is how Rudy pretty much fucked over the world.
Welcome to this episode of Rudy Fucks the World.
Yeah, my father needs this berry. My mother's always saying he doesn't have the berries to make any changes around here.
I know, I love how everyone's just like, what, you caused the earthquake? Okay, we'll just blame you. Like, dude. Mom! Why do you always cause so much trouble?
Tony or Rudy?
Yes.
I came to get these berries to heal Father's wounds.
Are you two okay? What was that earthquake all about? I think that was Hat Dude.
Oh. I have always told you not to come here.
Hey, you're safe. That's all that matters. Let's go home now.
Yeah, they wouldn't have had to fight this if the dog didn't stop them.
I know, right? It's the dog's fault.
Yeah, blame the dog.
Or you just be like, I got this shit. Ain't no big deal. I got it.
A zombie!
Zompire.
Yeah, this isn't the zombie that you usually see in the movies. If they were, if they were zombie movies, it would be very different movies.
They start things off, you know. Oh, right, I could have shot it.
Yeah, Rudy knows how to be kind of flashy with things. Oh, God, his breath!
Jeez. He's just not taking any crap from this thing today. Bastard.
Making a forest? Yeah.
Yeah, that's why I hit it with the sword. Oh, yeah, that's right.
Yeah, to build the force power.
Yeah.
So the way this game works, various actions that you do build your force power gauge, and then you can use that gauge to activate special attacks. Kind of like a limit break in Final Fantasy.
Yeah, a bit.
Yeah, just it's a little more customizable and like a little... There's different ways to use it.
Mm-hmm.
It's actually a little more creative than Final Fantasy is.
You just pretty much shoot the crap out of it and it dies. You have to heal a time or two.
Yeah, that's as close to strategy as Rudy gets.
Just shoot the crap out of it until it dies. Sometimes he does that.
It says arm lock on, but that's its chest, not its arms. Stupid Rudy.
Oh, crap. Heal or... shoot again. I think I can withstand another attack. Watch, I get killed.
I'm waiting for it.
As long as he doesn't rotten breath me again, I should be able to do it.
Even if he does, you should be okay, unless it has, it like hits really high on the damage.
Okay, we're good.
Crit.
Dang. He's just not taking it. I like that with Condition Green. I believe they did it in the first game too, that as soon as you hit Condition Green, which is a full, yeah, they did, which is full force gauge, it clears any negative status.
That's a really interesting way to do things.
Oh, I have stories about that one in Wild Arms 3.
Rudy has gone up a level.
So when I discovered the Creeping Chaos in Wild Arms 3, they, you know, they'll put every status in the game on you. And, well, Clive was the only one I had that was, you know, that would repel most of those. The ones that didn't kill you, like poison and whatnot. So, basically, the rest of my characters all died of poisoning. And the only way I got through that fight was by waiting for Clive to take enough hits to hit Condition Green and fire on them. Three creeping chaoses.
Well, at least you had a full force bar to do something with.
I think it was three of them, but oh my god. And I was determined not to give in on that fight. So that's basically, I mean, I think I was at that for over an hour. All right.
Rudy casts the heal berry at the regenerating zombie. Why? What reasoning does he have to do that right now? The healing light from the holy berry reduces the zombie to sludge.
Sorry, Tony's dad. Yes, you're remaining crippled for a while longer.
Yeah, you could have kept a single berry off of there.
I think he was crippled in Ultra Code, sticking this one.
Wow, you've defeated the zombie.
The zompire.
What happened, Mom?
You have brought tragedy to the entire village of Surf. You know what we say, Surf's up. I know you. You possess the arm, the forbidden power. I know I shouldn't have, but I looked through your stuff the other day.
Dude!
And you're the creep!
Dude!
I'd rifle through your things, but I think you're the weird one.
Yeah, you're the bad guy here.
The arm has brought doom to us all. No, that was Rudy. Don't blame his gun. The Dream Chaser, Rudy, has cursed us all. That earthquake was probably caused by Rudy. Yes, not the gun. This guy gets it.
I know, and he's just standing there like, yeah, okay, just blame me. It's cool. It's cool. Everyone else always does. I saved your lives, but...
Yeah, be quiet, everyone. Rudy, thanks for saving the boy.
And all our asses.
But you opened the forbidden path and put us all in danger.
Your kid opened the forbidden path. I came after him.
You also possessed an arm. I have two myself. You will be judged for this according to our village law. Do you agree, Rudy?
Nope.
I'm sorry, Rudy. Even though you're a dream chaser, you still have violated our law. We must judge you. You have no choice, Rudy. Please come with us.
Yeah, you can't talk your way out of it, and I've tried.
We must get back to the village at once. Rudy will be judged there. Yeah, maybe we can get McDonald's on the way back. Make the kids happy.
You know, I could just imagine if they, like, tried to give him a death sentence, he'd fucking take it instead of just shooting his way out of there.
The boy brought a terrible omen to the village. We must do something. He's just a dream chaser. It may sound cruel, but he may bring harm upon us all.
When the seal was broken, it caused an earthquake that damaged the entire village.
Oh, you can move now.
Oh, good. I'm not frozen.
No, I'm just going to sleep. Alrighty.
We all agree, then. We'll ask him to leave. The ultimate punishment. Asking him politely to leave. I took him in, so I'll inform him of our decision.
My God, just take your sweet time walking over here, man.
Yeah, don't help out, Rudy.
Were you eavesdropping, Rudy?
Yep. No, you were speaking directly under him in the same house. How could you not? How could he not hear you?
Then you know what we've decided. I must ask you to pack your things and leave. And please, don't come back.
Take your shit and go. All right, well, that's just enough time to finish Rudy's prologue. Pretty much, so I guess we'll save it here and we'll call it for this episode.
That sounds good to me. Thank you all for joining us for another episode of MHP Gaming. Like, comment, and subscribe as you see fit. And check our description below to find our Discord. Head there and suggest games you want us to make each other play in the future. Other than that, see ya!